Can you take us inside the boat and what had to happen in that last race for Texas to win? Because we were behind Michigan and then we were starting to eke up and it didn't look like we had it at all. And then all of a sudden it appeared that the team plugged into machine mode because they went faster on the last 500 meters than they did any part of the race. They were at almost, they were over 12 miles an hour. Yep. Can you take us into what had to happen inside the boat for that to even,
Great question. I think what had to happen is everything that we talk about on a daily basis and that we work on throughout, you know, so within our team, I say that the race, you know, they just have to get to the 1,000 meter mark in position to win, you know, get into position to win at the 1,000 meter mark. And that's where when Michigan shot off, you know, when Michigan took off, that was fine. Even when Stanford got ahead, we were in position, you know, to win at the 1,000 meter mark. And then what I like to say is the best thing, the most motivating thing that everyone can hear in rowing is we're moving. You know, when you know that, you know, if you're behind and you are gaining on the who's in the lead, adrenaline kicks in. You know, and it's really important for adrenaline when the race is at the toughest moment at 1250 meters, the middle of the third 500, you want adrenaline working in your favor. You know, so we work on that and we talk about that all the time. So if we can start moving or at least holding on at that most critical moment, we're in good shape. You know, so that's where, and like with 500 meters to go and, you know, if you followed along, like Stanford was rowing 38, 39 strokes per minute. We were rowing 36, 37 strokes per minute. So a lower cadence, but which meant like, okay, we have another gear still left in us. And the team knows that. They know what's going on. And we've worked on that. So then when they get to the last 250, it's like, all right, now time for that extra kick. And when they hear and they know that they can step up and they start to hear the coxswain say, we're moving. Adrenaline starts to go. And what I say, you know, and even I'd say to the team, like information is motivation. So the 250 to go, you've got 30 strokes. And if you hear 30 strokes, we're one seat back, 30 strokes to win, like, boom, like, you know, like I start getting chills, like, all right, they can do that. So then like, okay, 20 strokes, even they're like, all right, you know, 10 strokes, you know, we're ahead, like, adrenaline starts going. And so that's where like that final kick. So, and that's, I think oftentimes that's the key in those races where it's so hard, you've got to get the right motivation at the right time, you know? So,
you know, you just describing that made chills, right? It's like, I could feel that listening to the announcers on Sunday, they were even pulling for you. You know, they said Texas clearly put their boots on and, you know, they were fantastic. So so it's all on the coxswain because the rowers are not looking at the other boats. They're just in the zone, right?
Right. Lot gets put on the coxswain to follow the plan that we have and also know what's going on with everyone else. And, yeah, so the coxswain is part, you know, jockey for a racehorse, you know, minus the whip, of course. You know, but part psychologist, part motivator, part coach, you know, race plan. And, you know, I kind of say like the coxswain's tone can shift from airline pilot, you know, like you're sort of an airline pilot in the first 500 meters, like, all right, Texas, we're rowing 36 strokes a minute, smooth and steady. This is exactly what we want to be doing. And then at the halfway, you start to turn into the motivator. You know, maybe the motivational speaker, like, yes, I can. Yes, I can. You can do it. And then the last 250, she turns into the drill sergeant. Like, I need more. You can give me more. You know, so it's sort of a, you know, what happens within the coxswain seat, within the coxswain's voice changes throughout the race. And the rowers just tuned into that. And like, all right, go for it.